Hello, my name is Horst Jens. I'm from Vienna, Austria, and I teach Python to children. Variables and expressions. We've learned how to import a library and call functions. The next step is to make our code more flexible. What if we could take the drawing code and put it in our own functions? Then we could write custom functions to draw trees, houses, even rainbows. Our code could look like this. Creating flexible function isn't just for drawing. Functions are the basic building block of almost every type of programming. If you're running a program, it's just functions built on top of functions built on yet more functions. To be able to create our own functions, we need to cover three things. How to use variables, this chapter. How to write expressions, this chapter. How to create our own functions, the next two chapters. How to use variables. A variable is a value the computer stores in memory that can change. That is, it varies. Here's a quick example. What will the code above print? It will print 5. X is a variable. The equals is called an assignment operator. It assigns the value on the right side to the variable on the left. Here's another example. Very similar, but something is different. What will it print? The code above prints X. Why not 5? Because. If there are no quotes, the computer evaluates code like a mathematical expression. If there are quotes, we treat what it is between the quotes as a string of characters and don't change it. In fact, that's what we call the characters between the quotes, a string, which is short for string of characters. We don't call it text. The following code won't print at all. The code above will fail because the computer will think that it should evaluate "have a great day" as a mathematical expression. It isn't, so the computer gets confused and generates a syntax error. That's why we need quotes. Variable and function names. Variable names and function names follow the same rules. There are names you should use, names you shouldn't use, and names you can't use. Variable names should be descriptive, all lowercase, and if you have multiple words, separate the words by an underscore. Variable names can't start with a number, nor have a space or any symbol other than an underscore. Sometimes we want to create a variable that won't change. We call these variables constants. By convention, these variable names are in all uppercase. They are the only variables that use uppercase. Good variable names help make code readable. For example, what does this code do? It's hard to tell. Here we use variables to separate the formula from the numbers. A bit easier to change the values and a bit easier to figure out the formula. Instead of using short variable names, if we use descriptive variable names and comments, the code is very easy to understand. Good variable names make code readable. Even a non-programmer could scan that code and understand what it does. Straightforward code requires less effort to find problems. Therefore, take the time to name your variables well. How to create expressions. Great. We are partway there. To manipulate data with a computer, we use expressions. An expression is simply a mathematical equation. Using operators in expressions. Expressions use operators. That's just a fancy word for symbols like addition, plus, and subtraction, minus. Here's an example. As you can probably guess, this will print out 15. We call the plus sign an operator. Here are some other operators. Plus, addition, minus, subtraction, star, multiplication, star, star, exponentation, raised to the power, slash, division, slash, slash, integer division, round down, rounds down, percent sign, modulus, gives remainder of division. There are two things that don't work like mathematics. First, there is no juxtaposition used to multiply items. Second, the equals is not an algebraic equality. Juxtaposition doesn't work. Juxtaposition doesn't work for multiplication. For example, the following will not work. You can rewrite the code above to work by explicitly multiplying. easy enough. Just remember to use star anytime you want to multiply. Assignment operators. The equal doesn't work the same as in algebra. The equal takes the expression to the right and evaluates it. The resulting value is stored into a variable on the left of the equals. For example, this stores a 7 into the variable x. In algebra, this next line of code would be okay. It does not work in Python, however, because the only thing that can be on the left is a variable. Variables can be used in the expression. For example, this example works fine and stores 7t's into z. This next set of code doesn't work. On the left of the equals, in the last line, there's an expression. We need just a single variable for it to work. The fact that the equal sign isn't an algebraic equality allows us to do some strange operations that doesn't make any sense in algebra. Look at this set of code and the comments that explain it. Increasing a variable. What if we want to change a value stored in a variable? We need to use an assignment operator. For example, take a look at this code. It prints the number 4 twice. First, we assign 3 to x. Then, every time we print, we add 1 to x. We aren't changing the original value of x, so we don't print 4 and then 5. The variable x only holds the number 3. Take a look at this example. This example prints 3. It does add 1 to x. But it does nothing with the result. We don't print it. Just like the prior example, the number in x doesn't change. Now look at this example. We use the assignment operator. We store into x the result of x plus 1. It does increase the value stored in x and therefore we print out a 4. Note. It can be confusing to learn when to use x plus 1 and when to use x equals x plus 1. Remember, the former does not change the value of x. Increment-decrement operators. The equal symbol isn't the only assignment operator. There are the other assignment operators. Equal, assignment, plus equal, increment, minus equal, decrement, star, equal, multiply, slash equal divide. Because statements like x equals x plus 1 are so common, we can shorten this using the plus equal assignment operator. Examine this code to see how it works. Remember, if you want to increase or decrease a variable, you need to use an assignment operator. Oh, and a common mistake is to mix the plus and plus equals operator as shown in this example. It doesn't just add 1 to x, it doubles x and adds 1. Using expressions in function calls. Expressions are not limited to assignment statements. We can use expressions as parameters in function calls. This can be useful when you need a quick calculation. For example, what if we want to draw a circle in the center of the screen? By creating variables for the height and width of the screen, we can set the screen size and also do a quick calculation to find the screen center. In this example, we use constant variables for the screen width and height. Then use some math to calculate the center of the screen. The great thing about this is that the variables which control the screen size can be changed, and the circle will automatically be recentered. Order of operations. Python will evaluate expressions using the same order of operations you learned in math. For example, this expression does not correctly calculate the average. The first operation to be calculated is 98 divided by 5, rather than adding up the numbers. That is, the computer calculates this equation instead. What we need is an equation where the division happens last. 90 plus 86 plus 71 plus 100 plus 98 altogether divided by 5. By using parentheses around the addition in our code, this problem can be fixed. Printing variables. How can you print variables and text together. Say you've got a variable answer and you want to print it. Based on what we've learned so far, you can do this code. But that just prints out bananas on a line by itself, not very descriptive. You can combine the answer with the additional text by using a comma. Here's an example. That example was better, but it is missing punctuation. The code attempts to add a period at the end. Unfortunately, it doesn't work quite right. We've got an extra space before the period. The comma adds a space when we use it in a print statement. We don't always want that. We can instead use a plus sign as shown in this example. That gets rid of all the spaces. So we need to add a space inside the quotes where we want it as shown here. That works until you try to print a variable that holds a number instead of text. Try this example. That code generates a brand new error we haven't seen yet, a type error. What is the problem? The computer doesn't know how to put text and numbers together. If you add two numbers, 20 plus 20, you got 40. If you add two strings, quote 20, quote, plus, quote 20, quote, you get, quote, 2020, quote. But the computer has no idea what to do with a combo of text and numbers. So the fix is to use the string function, which converts the number to a string text. Here's an example. Yes, this is a bit complex, but wait, there's an easier way. We can print variables using a formatted string. Later we will spend a whole chapter on formatted strings, but here's an example to get started. Note, this example starts the string with an F before the quote, and the variable we want to print goes in curly braces. This is the way I recommend printing variables. Again, we will cover it in more detail in a later chapter. Review. In this chapter, we introduced the concept of using variables and using them in expressions. Expressions are made up of both variables and operators, which are used to tell the computer how to combine the values. We also showed how to print variables along with text. We will use this knowledge to create our own functions in the next chapter.